Hi everyone, welcome to another video on I Have Read That Book channel. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to subscribe and be part of I Have Read That Book family and learn things for free. So in this video, we're going to talk about digital image processing and everything associated with it. There are going to be a few videos in this series. So let us start. Okay, before understanding digital image processing, let us understand what an image is all about. So as you can see, this is an image and it has varying intensity of colors everywhere. Some parts are bright, right? And some parts are dark, right? Some parts are bright and others are not so bright. Some parts are dark and others are not so dark. Why is an image like that? To understand that, take this image as a two-dimensional figure. In fact, you can do this with any image you have. Here I have divided this image in small boxes, right? And you will see vertical and horizontal lines here. And let us say the points where these lines intersect are X, Y. Okay? And if I consider an image this way, X and Y are plane coordinates and this whole image is a two-dimensional function f of X, Y. Now these points are called pixels and some of them I have shown as white dots, but you can call all these intersecting points pixels. Okay, all these intersecting points are called pixels. And the intensity of an image is actually the value of function f of X, Y. Amplitude of function f at any pair x, y is called intensity of an image at that point. Now what I mean by that and why it is important to understand it is because it decides the brightness. I hope you know not all the colors have the same brightness. We have light red, we have dark red, and when you store a picture inside a computer, these pixels have some value which describes how bright that pixel is or what color it should have. And these pixel values are discrete or distinct quantities or digits. That is why this image stored inside a computer is called a digital image, right? If you're holding it in your hand, it is just an image. And when it is inside computer, it is digital image. Now this is an image. When it goes inside a computer, this is how you can actually understand the concept of digital image. This is your XY plane and these are XY coordinates. This is two-dimensional plane, XY coordinates, and these intersecting points are XY pair, right? And they will have some value, all right? And digital image processing means processing of an image digitally, okay? Or processing of a digital image. And these digital images inside the computer are composed of finite number of elements having specific location and value. Yes, you're right. These finite number of elements are these points. They have specific location and some value. If you are familiar with these kind of functions f of x, y, you will understand we consider this part as 0, 0 and these are the increasing values of x and these are increasing values of y. So this point here, this will have the highest value for x and some lowest value for y. Similarly, when we go to this direction, the y values are increasing, x value will remain the same, right? And the location is changing, the value is changing. Okay, so all these elements, they have specific location and specific value. And these elements are called pixels or picture elements, or sometimes they are called PELs or PEL. And examples of digital image processing are photo editor, X-ray imaging, etc. is also an example of digital image processing. And in the next lecture, we will talk about components of digital image processing. If you found this video helpful, like it and share it. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. I will see you in the next video.